two of them after that. So with that, Coach.
Thank you, Mike. First of all, everybody, welcome. And I'm glad we had it. I think it looks like we have a pretty good turnout, and I appreciate that, and I'm sure Jamey does as well. And when we're done, we give the media an opportunity to ask the questions that they have. But when we're finished with the media, I think if all of you took the time to come here, any of you that have questions, we'll be glad to answer your questions as well. So this could be an extended press conference. Whether or not you guys want to keep the camera going, that's up to you guys. So I want to talk a little bit about you all by now have seen the press release on Jamey. So I think what he has done at Charleston Southern, what he's done at Coastal, pretty much speaks for itself. Any coach would be proud to have accomplished what he has already accomplished in his career. He will be a highly sought-after coach, I have no doubt, over the span of his entire career, and I feel blessed that we had the opportunity to get him. Now, I want to talk a little bit about my philosophy with regard to this and my thoughts on this before I actually turn it over to Jamey. Back in 2012, we actually got hired beginning in the middle of December or so. And I remember being criticized by some of the local people, some of the local media. Everybody was criticizing me back then anyway. But I remember being criticized that I wasn't moving fast enough to get the staff in place because I was going to miss the recruiting class. Well, let me give you my philosophy on that. First of all, when a staff is dismissed and a new staff is coming in, a lot of times you miss that recruiting class. When a coach leaves and you replace that coach, you normally don't miss that recruiting class at all. But the number one priority that I think I have as a head coach is that I've got to be able to bring in the right people that are going to work well with our student athletes and going to represent this university. That's the number one thing I've got to do. And I can't rush that. I can't make quick decisions on that. And that's the reason why back in 2012, we really only had about five people on the staff for actually quite a while. But that was because I felt it was that important. Well, that's the way I felt in the business world. That's the way I feel in coaching. And that's certainly the way I feel today. Because it's that important to me, it's important that I keep what I call my own portfolio of coaches that I kind of keep in mind. So at every position, I have a list of coaches that I follow that I either keep in contact with or have somebody that represents me, keeps in contact with them. So I have an idea kind of what they're doing, how they're doing, they're happy, what's going on, et cetera. And when Dave had the opportunity to get the job at Temple, and Dave did a great job for us, and I wish him and Chris and his girls all the very, very best up there. He'll do a great job there. The number one guy that I knew that I really genuinely wanted was Jamey. And I've gotten to know Jamey a little bit personally over the span of the last couple of years, but certainly we've been competing against each other over the span of the last 4 years. He has beaten us significantly over the span of those 4 years, which is not something I'm proud of, but all that does is improve the respect that I have for that man. So the priority to me, bringing in the right coach, is absolutely number one in my head. He's the guy that's going to work with our student athletes. He's the guy that's going to represent this university. If I didn't have the right guy, I would wait till as long as it took to find that right person. So, with regard to Jamey specifically, again, as I said, I think his record speaks for itself. He's certainly been a great competitor of ours. But for us, it's about the two things we have in the country that we have here that no one in the country has is we're the only program in the nation that doesn't have specific rules. We have a standard. We call it BAM. We expect our coaches, our players, anybody connected with our program to stand on their own 2 feet, take responsibility for themselves, treat others with dignity and respect, and they're going to live with the consequences of their actions. That is the foundation upon which we build our program. If I don't believe a coach coming in the door can't epitomize that or can't truly buy into that, no matter what his record is, no matter how good he's been, no matter how well he speaks, that won't be a coach that ever gets hired here. The other piece of that is we are the only program in the nation, that gives up 30 minutes of practice every week because we spend time talking to our players about what life after football is going to be like. And we do that by not talking about football. We talk about things that are relevant, that are going on in the world. Examples of that. Every year we have the anniversary of 9/11. Doesn't take too long to talk about 9/11. But what the guys need to understand, I firmly believe that the biggest threat to mankind today is terrorism. And I don't know how much time we're spending with it on the classroom, but I know that's one of the most important things going on in the globe. And I know our guys are not that conscious of it. So we go back and we talk about the roots of terrorism. How did it happen? Why did it happen? How do they execute today? What really takes place there? So we live in the greatest country in the world, but there are hundreds of thousands of people in the world that won't hesitate to give up their lives because they think what we do is evil. That's critical that our guys understand that. All right, that leads to, well, how do you protect ourselves from the terrorists? That has something to do with the military. Well, we can only pray, frankly, that our military and political leaders make the right decisions that they believe, really believe in, no matter what kind of ramifications that may have as far as their actual careers go. Well, what kind of role do we play in that? Well, we live in a democracy. Democracy, we have the right to vote. In 120 years of college football, and I would think that our university and all Horry County and all of South Carolina, maybe not the state of Alabama, but everybody else understands what this means. In 120 years of college football, Division FBS, FCS, Division II, Division I, Division III, Division NAIA, we're the only football program, other than maybe some of the military academies, only football program ever whose entire team voted for the President of the United States on Election Day, or for the other person that didn't win that. I couldn't be more proud of that. So that's part of LAF, and we get involved with many other things. So it's the foundation upon which we build our program. We've got BAM, and then we do everything we really truly can as a football staff, to make sure that our commitment is taking care of student athletes and preparing them for what life is like later on. Jamey believes in that with everything that he's got in him. So from a principal perspective, what kind of teacher is he? I think he's outstanding. What kind of recruiter is he? I think he's outstanding. What kind of program has he run? He should be incredibly proud of that. I think without question, we were getting the right guy. I thought we were getting a special person. That's number one. Number two, you got the right man. You got the right football coach. That's a pretty solid combination to me. So because of, frankly, what he's been able to accomplish, because he's a sitting coach, because he's got opportunities, he's going to have opportunities his entire career to do other things, I thought it was fitting, and I thought he deserved to receive the title of associate head coach. Jamey never asked for that title. I felt he deserved that title, and I offered it to him. Of course, he accepted that. Now, because of that title, all of a sudden we start to hear, well, now, is Jamey the coach in waiting? Has Jamey been promised the job? Blah, blah. There's more talk about that than there is anything else. Well, there are a couple things associated with this. Number one, I'm still coaching here, okay? Number one. No, now, we've talked about my career. That's come up a number of times. I want to be at Coastal Carolina, but if I had the opportunity to win a Super Bowl, if I had the opportunity to win the BCS National Championship, that'd be something any coach in the country would have to seriously consider, as I would have to consider. Most coaches would, oh, I would never do that. I'll stay the rest of my life. They're lying to you, okay? That's one reality. I don't believe I ever get that opportunity. I believe I will retire one of these days from Coastal Carolina. I'll be the one, unless we do poorly, then Matt and Dave can make that decision, but I'll be the one that'll decide that. Then in terms of a successor to me, I don't believe in coaches in waiting because most of the time, frankly, the community and oftentimes the media, and sometimes internally, that becomes political. And when things are not going particularly well, there becomes some more friction, and you're looking to kind of mix the boat on that. I've had conversations about that with Bobby Bowden. So that's not something I'm crazy about or believe in. So Jamey is not a coach in waiting. He has not been promised the job. And I just assume, since that's dependent upon whenever I step down, I just assume not have to have that conversation all the time because I don't know when that's going to happen, number one. Number two, having said that, if I were to step down, we would be crazy not to treat somebody like Jamey with his background and his resume and his abilities as a serious candidate for the job. The number one thing for Coastal would be get the right person for that job. So that's the story as far as that goes. With that, I wanted to go over that, and with that, I just want to turn it over to Jamey. Jamey?
Thank you very much. You can clap if you want to. I know him. I told him to do that. So, but let me first say this. This is my birthday today, and this is the most people's ever been to my birthday in a long time, so I appreciate that. And what a birthday gift. What a birthday gift to be here.
By the way, that's why I got the associate head coach title. It was a birthday present.
So, but let me first say this. That is a it's an honor and privilege to be here, to be representing Coastal Carolina University. I've had a lot of respect for the program outside looking in, a lot of respect for Coach Moglia and his staff and what they've done. Obviously, the accomplishments they've made over the last 5 years are second to none. And to have the opportunity to be a part of that, to see how he runs his program, the band principles, the life after football, those are things that I have a lot of passion about and I wanted to be a part of. And to see how somebody with the success that he's had, how he's done that at a high level and continues to sustain that. So when he called me about this opportunity, it was obviously something that we had never talked about before per se, but something that I had on my mind. If I ever had the opportunity to work for somebody like him, it was something that I wanted to definitely pray through. I'm looking forward to being a part of this community, being part of this team, and continuing the tradition that's been laid before over the last several years since before him and the winning ways. And most importantly, just looking forward to working for student athletes that have a passion for this university, have a passion for being successful in what they do. And hopefully, as we make this transition to the Sun Belt, you'll be sitting in here with Sun Belt championships and bowl games and figuring out where you're going for the holidays. So thank you for allowing me to be here, and I appreciate Coach Moglia and Matt for this opportunity.
Were you surprised at all by this, by Coach approaching you here? Because we know, I understand you had been in the running for other head coaching jobs and everything else. How was this process for you?
A little surprised, I guess you could say. You know, we don't talk all the time, but during meetings and different things, we've got to know each other. So, but when I saw that somebody was leaving there, it wasn't something that I was thinking, oh, he's going to call me out of the blue. But we do have a relationship, and truth be told, if he hadn't called me, I might have reached out to him and let him know that I'd have been interested in that. So it's something that being around him, being a part of this program, something that I'd thought about before. Whatever he does, I'm gonna tell him. I'm gonna do. So he tells me I can talk. I can talk. If he tells me I can't, I won't. So
that's another good reason why I hired the guy. The guys, the associate. I want to go to the business world for a minute. Everybody's got a vice president title, executive this, executive that. The reality is, it's the real function behind a job is, what is your job? What is your responsibility? So the associate head coach, I think, is a prestigious title. It's a title. It's a title, and if I were not around, I would think that Jamey would take responsibility. If I'm sick, Jamey would take responsibility for what's going on in football. George Glenn would take responsibility for what's going on outside of football if we had to go through a temporary period of that. But it's a title, and Jamey's job is offensive coordinator. And as the offensive coordinator, he will have total authority over what we do from an offensive perspective with regards to our coaches, with regards to the recruiting there, with regards to our student-athletes. And I think many of you do realize that one of the things that I do, I won't hesitate to let a guy go if I feel I need to, but I delegate. And my guys are the ones that really do the coaching and deserve a credit for what we have going on. So the associate head coaching title is the title. So... that answer your question, Hex?
That's it.
Okay.
Yeah, Jamey, I want to talk about recruiting a little bit. What's happening now that you made this transition and moved up from Charleston to here? You know, take some of the guys that you've been looking at? I mean, how does that work?
Well, the majority of the class here is done. Obviously, they've done a great job with recruiting throughout the years. I think there's, if I'm not mistaken, maybe 3 or 4 spots left. So, the positions of need that we're trying to fill, I'm obviously going to get on the phone. Already been on the phone with some of those and continue to do that to get to know them as they prepare to come down and take visits here over the next 3 weeks. And then try to finalize that class. And if anybody that's we're competing against, try to get in there now that he's named us as, or named me as the offensive coordinator, so I can go in there and let them know it's official and this is who you're going to be working for and what we're going to be doing.
I know you can't talk about individual targets that you're looking at, but what are the positions of need in your mind now being the offensive coordinator?
Well, I'm still obviously learning that. I know I do know that we did have some quarterback issues last year, obviously, and so that's an area of need just to try to get some depth there. And I'm sure there's some other needs at some tight end and some other places like that. Quarterback's one I'm going to focus on right now because that's the main one I know about.
We lost this Henderson fella. I don't think he's coming back, is he?
I hope he is. I'll be a lot better, I can tell you that. So, but There's enough, obviously, most of his yardage I think he got against us the last few years, but there's a lot of guys that ran the ball fully well from my time remembering that was not his name as well. So I'm sure there's a lot of good depth here. They've done a great job recruiting and getting young people here, and I'm excited about that.
I'm pretty stunned about you leaving Charleston Southern after what you did down there. Is this just a chance to get on the higher level?
Well, I mean, I think that might be part of it. The main thing is you want to work with good people. You want to be somewhere that you feel like you have an opportunity to grow and learn maybe some differently. And Coach Moglia gives me that. I mean, he mentioned what he does is unique. And to be able to be a part of that and learn from him and learn from the other coaches here is something that I was craving and wanted to be a part of. And it wouldn't have been just anywhere. I mean, it had to be. For me, you know, being a head coach is, you know, you control everything. And when you go to an assistant, there's a different there. And so I wouldn't have went just anywhere. It had to be somebody that I respected and wanted to work for in a place I wanted to be. Obviously, I've been in South Carolina a while and been familiar, at least outside, with what Coastal stands for and what he stands for. It made it a no-brainer.
Coach, how did that take place when you guys somebody reached out to the other? How did that conversation go when you talked about Coastal?
Hey, you want to come? Sure. All right, let's go. But we'll work out the details later. So he talked about what was happening, the process. And then it was a big decision for me and my family. And we took some time to pray through that, if that was what we wanted to do with our family. And then you're leaving a team and leaving coaches. There's a lot that goes into that. And one thing you guys will hopefully have a chance to learn about me is I'm very passionate about what I do. I put my heart in anything I do. So I'm here. I'm going to invest roots here. My roots are going to be here. And so when you do that and then you end up leaving somewhere, it's hard. And so it took a lot of prayer just to make sure that this was where God was calling us. I mean, I felt that's what he was doing. He was calling us to be here and invest in this community. And after we talked through that and talked through some of the details of it, said yes and then tried to keep it quiet, and that didn't work very well. So
I think I want to add something to that, though, Mark, and that is when I made the call to Jamey, everybody knew at the time that Dave had gotten the other job or was getting the other job. And I simply said to Jamey, I said, like, here's what I believe in philosophically. And we talked about BAM and LEF. I said, here's what I believe in as far as offense goes. Here's what I believe in terms of delegation. Here's the type of program we run. Forget the football piece of it. The type of program we run. And if you have interest in this, you would be my first candidate. Now, in the meantime, I'm going to have other candidates. There are going to be potentially guys on the staff, outside guys, other people. And I need to pay attention to that. But if you think this is something you're interested in, we're going to wrap this up.
Well, we have a team meeting today, so after a coach gets to talk with them, I'll have a chance just to introduce myself. I'm sure there's a preconception of who I am based off being an opponent. We'll have a little have to talk through that a little bit. But one thing I do know is there's good kids here, and they want to be successful. And if coach tells them there's an opportunity to be successful, they'll buy in. But I'm sure a lot of them don't like me right now, so they'll end up loving me.
How much did that come up in the process? How much trouble you had with Charleston Southern?
You mean you talk? Who you talking to?
Yeah.
Me? How much trouble we had with Charleston Southern? Yeah. Well, no. I think from a defensive perspective, they're delighted. Okay, the defense is jumping up and down. They're happy. Okay, I think from an offensive perspective, I think there is a reputation out there. I believe that exists. On Jamey, that he's a triple option guy. Well, since he's been running against us, he's been running a spread option. And when we talk philosophy, you go with that's part of why we're in sync offensively. You go with the type of offense that you believe in, but your ability to adapt and adjust to what your players can do is critical to that. How many times over the span of our last 5 years together where I've talked about it's our ability to adjust, it's ability to play three quarterbacks because we're not going to ask that like 2 years ago when Alex went down. It's because we're not going to ask this guy to do what Alex can do because he can't do what Alex can do. But he can do what he can do, and that guy can do what he can do. So how do you adapt and adjust? One of the things that I think is a big deal, and one of the reasons why we have a competitive advantage most of the time is we don't ask our guys to do something they can't do. And if we do that, then it's on us when it's really not working out. So I think from that perspective, Jamey's going to talk to our offensive guys. He'll talk to the whole team today, and then I'll spend some time with the offensive guys. And then maybe after that, you plan to spend a few minutes with the quarterbacks?
Mm-hmm. Have you ever given any thought to how much longer
Well, yeah, well, I kind of think I've addressed that because you guys asked me that probably at every press conference we've had for the last 4 years or so, 3 years. So as I've said, I believe in this, and I spend a lot of time with our players. When you're picking a career path, there are two things you got to have. And I talk about this under the concept of spiritual soundness that some of you may very well be familiar with. You have to understand yourself well enough to know who you are. And if you know who you are, then you need to understand what your skill sets are. So when you're making a decision as to which way you may go in life, career-wise, number one, do you have the skill sets for that? Too many people really don't ask themselves that question. Do you have the skill sets to be successful in that particular field? And many people go down a field because they're attracted to it, or that's the only field they can think about, or whatever. That's a bad mistake. If you have those skill sets, you still got to ask yourself one other question. Is this something I'd be passionate about? Is this something that turns me on? Is this something that I want to do? The answer to both of those questions are yes, then those are great fields for you to go down. There's probably only two career paths I'd be any good at, but I knew enough about myself to pick those two career paths. So I love doing what I'm doing. I do believe I'm good at it. I do believe I'm different than most in terms of that. And I'm going to coach for as long as I feel strongly about that. So at some point in time, am I going to coach at like 90? Yeah, probably not.
I believe in you.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, that's part of it that did excite me. I've seen the talent firsthand that they've been able to bring in here and how they've been producing. So I know they're able to get guys that are really good football players. So hopefully what you can do is take what they have here as recruiting new guys. You bring them in and try to continue a lot of the positive things that have happened, the way they've been able to run the ball, the way they've been able to throw it with, you mentioned the receivers and you forgot the quarterback Ross, all the great players. So we're going to try to take a lot of those things that they've been able to do and use it and hopefully continue it going forward.
Jamey, you were a candidate for several head coaching positions over the last couple of years, Georgia Southern in 2015, Furman, Chattanooga here last year. How many actual positions did you interview for of those schools or other schools?
Don't believe what you read in the news. I'll just put it that way. Don't believe what it is. So that's all I would say. Don't believe what you read.
Can you tell us where you interviewed, though? Or,
I'd rather not.
Well, how many different ways are you going to ask the same question, Al?
I'm sworn to secrecy.
What kind of offense are you going to run that year?
We'll be a spread. We'll take the best. Coach and I talked. We'll take the best of what's worked here and try to blend it with some of the things that we've been able to do at Charleston Southern. Obviously, I believe in some option running, some type of option, so we're going to try to be a physical run game. But I'd be crazy not to try to use a lot of the things that have been going on here with the way we've been able to throw the football and move the football and implement that and try to blend the best of both. So I don't think you'll see tons of changes, but hopefully my mentality is I'd like our guys to have an identity up front and be a physical football team. And when we need to run the ball, we're going to run the ball. But still throw it around some too. So it'll be back and forth.
It may not be your priority taking the position, but did you receive a pay raise by coming here?
Did I?
You did. It was 11%. Yeah, it was 11% raise. So you surprised I knew that?
I was surprised.
Yeah.
whether I did or not wouldn't have mattered.
Well, if I knew that, you would have got an 11% cut.
I didn't tell him that beforehand.
And you said your birthday, did you turn 40?
I did. So.
That's why I like bringing in guys my age.
So. Coach Moglia, you have Ricky Matthews as your defensive coordinator, now a really talented offensive coordinator. Where do you see this program in the next 5 years? It's going into the Sun Belt?
Well, I think kind of what we see going in the Sun Belt is that the number one priority for us is to be competitive. And the sooner we can be competitive, the better off we're going to feel about that. And the two things that you want to be able to try to achieve in the Sun Belt, of course, you want to compete for the league championship because that's far tougher, frankly, than getting to a bowl game. And you want to be able to go to a bowl game every year. So once we kind of get where we need to get to, and hopefully that's soon, I would expect to go to a bowl game every year, and I would expect to be competitive for the league championship. If anybody missed that, by the way, since there was a microphone going along, the from somebody that's had an opportunity to actually work with Jamey, he thinks we made a great decision.
Anyone else? Anything? All right, thank you all.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.